Man, stop it. Stop. Good gifts. Not the bad gifts.
The good ones.
That's what it's about.
That's what it's about. That's good gifts.
Authorities in France have released the boss of the Telegram messaging app, Pavel Durov. The tech entrepreneur was granted conditional release with bail of 5 million euros. He must also remain in France and report to police twice a week. Russian-born Durov was arrested in Paris over the weekend. Earlier, he was charged with violations relating to the messaging app. Prosecutors say Durov is complicit in crimes committed by others on his platform. Durov's detainment came as part of an inquiry opened last month involving 12 alleged criminal violations, including complicity in selling child sexual abuse material, complicity in drug trafficking, fraud, abetting organised crime transactions and refusing to share information with investigators when required to by law, for example, to combat terrorism.
Yo, 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 what's up, people? We is back. Another day on Keeping G News. And they are, I would say we in Baltimore, but we in multiple states. And the reason why we is in multiple states and multiple cities is because we talking about somebody that the feds is alleging is a multi-million dollar marijuana distributor. Now, y'all, we living in a day and time where marijuana is damn near illegal. Most places actually is legal. You can have up to 6 pounds, I mean not 6 pounds, but a few plants. You can have up to a few ounces on you. Some places, man, I'm talking about marijuana laws is relaxed. But what came in with these relaxed laws is a new form of hustling. It's a new form of hustling, y'all. And I'ma keep it real. I always seen these things, you know, on the internet. You get these little inboxes and messages like, yeah, hi, let me on Telegram. I got this on Telegram. And I always thought it was a scam. But come to find out, y'all, selling drugs, I guess, on Telegram is a real thing. So real that not too long ago, the owner of Telegram got arrested. How many people know that? And the reason he got arrested, because he was refusing to give up information. I think it was a case that happened in France. Don't get me the line. I can't remember exactly what country the case was in. But he was refusing to cooperate with the police because the thing about Telegram and what's supposed to make Telegram private is that it's encrypted, but it's not end-to-end encrypted. And I think that's what lead a lot of people down the wrong way, and they think that the feds can recover these conversations. But in this video, you're going to find out that they can. But when I was talking about the internet, and the internet birthed the new form of hustling, because back in my day, back when I was young, you had to come outside to get some money. Even if you ultimately transitioned that into your phone. But you had to be outside at one point or another. Well, today is different. Today is different. Now, I don't know if it's a good or a bad thing. To be honest, coming from where I come from and the age I'm at, I don't understand the point. I would be too scared to hustle off the internet. But it's a real thing. And people is making buku money off of it. So in this video, y'all, I'm going to introduce y'all to somebody named Mikolas, a.k.a. One Buckets. In February 2023, detectives with the Baltimore Police Department, BPD, contacted the DEA and advised they were investigating the non-fatal shooting of an individual identified as Michael Mikolas Jr. Detectives explained that Mikolas had recently been involved in what they believe was a drug deal gone bad, where Mikolas was shot at but not injured. During that investigation, detectives recovered over 5 pounds of marijuana and over 100,000 in bulk U.S. currency from Mikolas' rental vehicle. Approximately a week later, in a separate incident, BPD arrived at the 3800 block of Wabash Avenue in Baltimore, Maryland in response to a report of a shooting. Mikolas, who was located at the scene, had been shot multiple times in the pelvic region. Due to the severity of his injuries, he was transported to Maryland Shock Trauma for immediate medical attention. Investigating officers discovered several shell cases on a roadway in a nearby apartment complex parking lot. Investigating officers also located a vehicle with significant amounts of blood in the driver and passenger areas, as well as other vehicles and property damaged by fired bullets. A canvas of the area resulted in an investigation recovering multiple pounds of marijuana that Mikolas attempted to discard prior to police arrival. Mikolas refused to cooperate or provide additional information to detectives during their investigation. In December 2023, in a follow-up to this initial investigation, I utilized an undercover Instagram account to monitor the Instagram accounts of suspected drug dealers and money launderers, including Mikolas. I identified an Instagram account labeled One Buckets that was viewable to the public. This account contained several photographs of Mikolas, which led me to believe that One Buckets account was used by Mikolas. I have also corroborated through Mikolas' social media posts as well as intercepts on wiretaps that Buckets is a moniker utilized by Mikolas. As the Instagram account, I viewed photographs of Mikolas posing with large amounts of cash. In some of these photographs, thousands of dollars in bulk US currency and pound quantities of marijuana can be seen. I also viewed video posted by Mikolas that showed large amounts of suspected drug proceeds with his personal diamond necklace laid across the money as depicted below. Furthermore, the Instagram account promoted a Telegram page where Mikolas marketed pound quantities of marijuana for sale. Mikolas listed different strains of marijuana he had available as well as prices from as low as $600 to upwards of $1,500 per pound. Mikolas claimed to have the lowest prices on the East Coast and the ability to ship marijuana worldwide. The Telegram account listed two telephone numbers including 410-459-7983 to place a marijuana order as depicted below. Based on the above described events, coupled with photos and videos on Mikolas' Instagram account, I believe Mikolas is the leader of a well-structured nationwide marijuana trafficking organization that generated significant amounts of drug proceeds, and that Mikolas and others were involved in money laundering and concealing the nature, source, location, ownership, or control of those proceeds. Since the inception of the investigation, agents have utilized numerous techniques, including undercover purchases, surveillance, search warrants, GPS tracking, and other investigative techniques to further investigate the drug proceeds of Mikolas DTO. Over the course of these interceptions, investigators identified DTO members operating under Mikolas' direction in various cities throughout the United States. Investigators were able to identify a source of supply responsible for supplying Mikolas DOT with thousands of pounds of marijuana. To date, throughout this investigation, investigators have conducted enforcement operations leading to seizures of approximately 300 pounds of marijuana, firearms, and over 3 million in bulk U.S. currency, and other evidence of drug trafficking and money laundering. Michael Mikolas Jr. Mikolas is the leader and mastermind behind a multi-million dollar marijuana distribution network operating in Baltimore, Maryland, Richmond, Virginia, the greater New York area, and Allentown, Pennsylvania. Mikolas is also the user of Target Telephone 9 and Target Telephone 12. Mikolas also sources marijuana for illegal distribution and laundering his drug proceeds with the assistance of you. Now, y'all, it's very important for me to show y'all those clips in the beginning, the very beginning, and what y'all just witnessed or just watched just now, because those clips in the beginning basically showed y'all some of the ads that you see online. You know, you probably didn't got some yourself. Where they tell you, look, get my Telegram. I got these type flavors. Get with me. I'm ready to go. Like I said, I never took it serious. But Mikolas, with the Fez is a legend, is one of those guys getting a lot of money. You see the pictures. Getting a lot of money. And he looked good doing it. I'm going to keep it all the way real. But when you sell drugs or you conduct your business so openly, it's not too hard for the feds to find you or for the police to start an investigation. But what you hear in this situation is the investigation actually started because in Baltimore, but because Mikolas was shot at and then shot. Looked like it was a lot of robbery going on. I don't know if he's from Baltimore or not, but y'all seen him in the clips in the beginning. For people that's from Baltimore, he hanging with White Boy. You know, White Boy with the bag, rest in peace to him. But that's how they got on him. And in these next clips I'm ready to play for y'all, you're going to find out that he wasn't really the whole source of the investigation. He was just a major player. Because a lot of people got arrested in this situation. It sounds like they all use Chinese-type names. Like, it's crazy, y'all. Like, yo, this Telegram drug selling is this new to me. They all use Chinese names. And multiple phones was getting distracted, you know, for information and wiretaps through this investigation. I think upwards of 12. But in these next clips, I didn't want to focus on everybody, you know, because this is a 104-115-page indictment. So I'm just going to stick to the part that Nicholas, a.k.a. One Buckus, played. On August 1st, 2024, at approximately 8:53 a.m., investigators intercepted communications between Nicholas utilizing Target Telephone 9 and Blank. The Blank, during the call, Nicholas told Blank, he said, he called his peoples and putting everything together now. Nicholas later said, yeah, but I'll call him periodically, like, I'll call him like 40 minutes. I already called him 10 minutes ago, so I'll call him in like, you know, like 40 minutes, 45 minutes. And just ask for an update, and he'll tell me. Nicholas also told Mac it's only 250. GPS location data from Blank, the target vehicle, and phone 8 showed that Blank had driven from Baltimore to New York the night prior. Based on that information and what was said during the call, investigators believe Nicholas was organizing a meeting between Blank and you and Zong to pick up 250 pounds of marijuana on behalf of Nicholas DTO. At approximately 9:45 a.m., agents established surveillance on Blank, who was parked in the vicinity of CubeSmart self-storage located at 266 Wild Avenue, Staten Island, New York. Mac was driving the target vehicle. Agents maintained surveillance of Blank as he drove to a local food establishment. At approximately 11:25 a.m., agents established surveillance in the vicinity of contained premises and observed two cars parked at the location. Zong, black 2023 Chevrolet Suburban bearing New York registration T706557C. The Suburban was parked backed in the driveway, and Liu 2023 BMW M235i bearing New York registration K119 was parked directly in front of the residence. At approximately 11:45 a.m., Blank, using Blank 38262 car target phone 6, used by you. During the call, Blank asked, hey, what's going on? Everything looking good? You replied, yeah, where are you right now? Said, I'm at dinner. I don't know exactly where, but not too far, about 10 minutes away from the hotel. You replied, I think we can do that at the hotel parking lot, so just wait there. I'm telling my guy to drive over there as soon as possible. Blank acknowledged, and you said, let me call him, and I'll give you the ETA right now. At approximately 11:48 a.m., investigators observed Blank returned to Fairfield Inn and Suites located at 209 Wild Avenue, Staten Island, New York, in target vehicle. At approximately 2:29 p.m., you call Blank during the call. You inform, yo, they are there, but it's on the next door. But the storage unit parking lot, it's a Suburban, black color. Blank asks, storage unit parking lot? You confirm, and Blank asks, okay. What color then? You said, just Suburban. At approximately 12:32 p.m., agents observed the target vehicle move from the hotel parking lot to the CubeSmart parking lot. Investigators could see that both Blank and Blank, another associate of Nicholas DTO, were in the vehicle. At approximately 12:41 p.m., Zong Suburban entered the CubeSmart parking lot and parked some distance away from the target vehicle. When Zong arrived, the target vehicle moved from its parking spot and parked directly next to Zong Suburban. While the cars were parked next to each other, agents observed both red trunk doors open and bags being transferred from the Suburban to the target vehicle. Based on the above described cars and surveillance and numerous other instances during which similar transfers were observed taking place, investigators believe the bags contained marijuana. At approximately 12:47 p.m., investigators observed Blank and Blank exit the CubeSmart parking lot in the target vehicle. Zong also exited the parking lot in the Suburban at the same time. Investigators saw an individual in the front passenger seat of the Suburban who later identified as Liu. At approximately 1:01 p.m., the Suburban returned to 715 Caton Avenue, Staten Island, New York. a location identified as Liu's residence. Upon parking, investigators saw Zong and Liu enter Caton's premises. Investigators saw that Zong was carrying a weighted bag that, based on the above-described calls and surveillance, investigators believe contained drug trafficking proceeds. At approximately 1:24 p.m., Liu exited the Caton premises with a black squared-off plastic bag containing the suspected drug proceeds, contained in a red circle depicted in the image below, and walked toward Liu's BMW make vehicle. Liu placed the bag into the BMW trunk, got in the driver's seat, and left the area in his car. Based on the above-described calls and surveillance, I believe Zong and Liu took 250 pounds of suspected marijuana from Caton premises and delivered it to Blank on behalf of Yu, MLO, DTO. I further believe that during the exchange, delivered drug trafficking proceeds to Zong and Liu on behalf of Mikla's DTO. I believe those proceeds were in the black bag Liu carried out of the Caton premises. On August 5th, 2024, at approximately 6:05 p.m., Yu, using Target Phone 6, called Target Phone 7, Zong. During the call, Zong told Yu he would be at 7:15 in 10 minutes. Zong told Yu he would pick up 9 bags of stuff. Based on my knowledge and experience, I understood this call to mean that Zong was going to the Caton premises 7:15 to pick up 9 bags of marijuana. I know from evidence gathered during the investigation that Yu, MLO, DOT, often refers to marijuana as stuff. Now, to keep it all real, y'all, this is a wide-range indictment. I'm talking about they locked up people in Seattle. They locked up people in New York. They are labeling these guys high-level drug suppliers. Got over $3 million in cash stolen. 300 pounds in buds stolen. And the whole way they had constructed their business, I ain't gonna lie, they had things in order. They had drivers, they had suppliers, they had people that was going to, you know, check on work and make sure everything ran smoothly. And they all connected through these Telegram phone numbers. But what you find out, or what I found out, because I always thought Telegram was encrypted, that you can get these phone records. You can tap these phones and you can go to jail. So this for all the Telegram hustlers, because I know it's probably some more out there. Your phone calls ain't safe, and you need to take this as an example and take this as a learning lesson. If this what you moving, you know, everybody think, well, it's marijuana, you know, it ain't really that much time. It ain't. But when you talk about money laundering and, you know, you transport money from out the United States and send them to these foreign countries and these foreign banks, yo, that turns federal. So you turn in a case or state case of selling marijuana, which probably be a slap on the wrist, to a Fed case to where maybe it's still slap on the wrist. But when you take money laundering in on there and things like that, man, you probably talking about 20 years in federal prison. 20 years in federal prison, like I said. But these guys got a lot of money. But I always tell y'all, is it worth making a lot of money in a short period of time or making less money and extending your time on the streets? Let me know in the comments, man. It's another day at KBG News.
Nigga can't do what I do. Y'all niggas can't copy me. Let's keep shit G. Let's keep shit G. Let's keep the shit G. Let's keep shit G. Let's keep shit G.